In this video, I'll be making a mash Lauter Tun for all grain homebrewing. This design does away with the expensive stainless steel mesh false bottom and uses commonly available copper plumbing parts to make a wort filter instead. This is a project that's been on my list for a while, and one that's great for extract brewers who are looking to save some money by going all grain. I claim no originality for this design, as it's all over the internet already. I'm just hoping to show the process in a clear, step-by-step manner. For this mash Lauter Tun, I'm using a 10-gallon igloo cooler, which is readily available at most hardware and grocery stores. I'm also using some stainless steel and copper fittings, the quantities of which are shown in the video description. I start by wrapping the ball valve and bulkhead fittings together, first wrapping the threads in a few wraps of Teflon tape. I previously removed the spigot that came with this cooler off camera, and the hole left over is slightly too small. To increase the hole size, I use a step drill to slightly enlarge the hole. Next is to insert the bulkhead through the hole. Please note that I have the gasket on the wrong side of the hole in this shot, as it should be on the outside of the cooler for a proper seal. I went back and fixed this later after leak testing. You'll want to tighten this up with a wrench as well for leak tightness. Now I'm using the lid of the cooler as a template for laying out the wort filter. This is a simple system, where later I'll be cutting a series of slots in the copper pipes connected here, which will filter out the larger grain particles from the wort. Forgive the crude metaphor, but this kind of works like a septic field, only in reverse. I'm using some old half-inch copper tubing that I took out when remodeling my kitchen for this. After deburring and filing slight chamfers on the ends of the cut pipe, I dry fit everything together. Once finished cutting the copper tube, you should have 4 7-inch long and 1 6.5-inch long piece, 9 1/4-inch long pieces, 4 elbows, 6 tees, an end cap, and 1 pressure cup with male threads. Note that these dimensions are only applicable to the model of cooler I'm using, so you'll have to adjust the fit to yours if different. Next is to dry fit the entire assembly. With everything put together, I test the fit in the cooler. Now I'll go about soldering some of the fittings together. I don't recommend soldering everything, as that makes it harder to clean after use. Rather, I'm soldering together the ends with all the fittings into one piece to save the headache of keeping track of all the fittings, while leaving the long tubing pieces loose. I'll mention now that I'm no expert at soldering. Also, I'm doing no joint prep besides applying flux, but it doesn't much matter since the purpose of this solder job isn't water tightness. All the solder has to do is hold the pieces together, which it'll do even in a poor solder joint that will see no real stress in use. For this purpose, I recommend water-soluble flux, which will wash off the filter with simple warm water. It is important to solder the joints with the assembly all fit together, since this will keep everything aligned in the end. After allowing the filter to cool, I mark where the tubes enter the fittings, as this will be the extent of the slots I cut. I also mark the up and down orientation of the filter itself to know where to cut the ends with the fittings. For cutting the slots, I'm using my table-mounted porta-band saw, which is a lot quicker than using a hacksaw. A hacksaw will definitely work, but it will take longer. I set up a stop block to make sure I only cut through half the pipe diameter. To keep the pipe in the same orientation, I use a vice grips pliers, which will register flat on the bed of the saw. I space the cuts every 1/8 inch to 1/4 inch or so. The spacing isn't very critical. For the soldered ends with the fittings, I'm only cutting slots in the portions between the T-branches. You will have some burrs due to cutting the slots, so be sure to remove these on the outside of the tubes with sandpaper. Now it's time to assemble everything together and do a leak test. Fill the cooler up about halfway with hot water, then use OxyClean to clean all the parts. I recommend doing this a few times to make sure you wash all the crud out. With the cooler filled with water, check the fittings for leaks. After washing everything out, the mash Lauter Tun is now finished. I'm looking forward to doing all grain beer batches from now on, which should cut down my beer costs quite a bit. Thanks for following along with this one, and don't forget to like and subscribe. As always, hope to see you on the next one.